Here we go. There's the foot button, which runs the spinning wheel, and it's connected into this box, which houses the electronics. Now, it's just a wooden box I found at the dollar store that happened to fit the job, but it's not going to last forever. It's going to be replaced. But the knob and the switch for the direction and speed both came with the PC board inside. And I'll make you a list for all that. And that runs my spinning wheel. Now I used PVC pipe and a flyer from an old spinning wheel with the original bobbin. This is from a Canadian production wheel I had. It had been cobbled together a couple of times. I got it for cheap, and this was about the only serviceable part after that. The motor I sourced from a local surplus store here in Canada called Princess Auto. They had them for a few dollars each, so I got a bunch. They're 12-volt hobby motors. They were not very expensive at all. I think they were under $5. Now, for my tension, I just used some cotton twine. You can see I drive here, which drives my flyer. And then I have my drag is on my bobbin. And it's just literally a loop of cotton thread with a spring to help with tension a little bit. And just a knob drilled into the... I just drilled a hole and drove a peg in about the right size and ran my thread through it. And that gives me my drag for my brake for my bobbin. So the whole thing, I paid about $50 for the original hunk of junk spinning wheel. So that was the most expensive part. It was I had bought the flyer and bobbin instead of making my own. Other than that, the parts were just a few dollars each. The electronics I got off of eBay, they were, I think, about $8. And then over there is the power supply, which steps down to a 12-volt to run this. And then that way, if I want, I can take that, disconnect the power supply, and connect it straight to a car battery. And I'd be able to spin pretty much anywhere with a 12-volt battery. Car battery, e-bike battery, any 12-volt battery will do. So, and that's my setup. Now, this isn't going to be final. This box is going to be replaced. I have some electronic hobby boxes that I'm going to be using. They're plastic with a metal bottom. And they'll just house the electronics a little nicer. I can give you a look inside. I use this just because it was handy. So, and it's just a small board that's mounted inside with a switch and a knob. So the switch controls the direction. It gives me, if I step on my little button down here, then my wheel goes round. So, and that gives me, those buttons give me not only my direction, forward and backward. Whoop. Oh, my backward doesn't want to work right now. I don't know why. Well, the backward used to work. The forward used to, now I'm not getting anything. I must have a loose... Oh, I got a loose connection here, I bet. So, but anyways, it's really... There's not much to it. It's cobbled together. And it works pretty well. So, the electronics are all eBay sourced. There's nothing special to them. Okay, there's forward. And there's reverse. And you can control the speed from as slow as you can get it. You can bring it right down, or you can bring it up to the point where it's about to fly apart. So it all depends on how you like to spin, how fast you can go. I also bought some smaller motors that I'm going to be trying to make some portable wheels with. I've written up some 3D printed patterns. I have a 3D printer as well, which is over there in my junk corner. So, and it's I'm going to use it to print all the parts I need for my next iteration of this, which is going to use a 5-volt motor or a 6-volt motor, much smaller design made to be ultra portable. So I'll let you know how that goes.